Namaste. Welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today we will make a Christmas cake for beginners. So it's a very simple cake. At the same time, it's very healthy too. And the ingredients required you can find at home easily. Those who don't have an oven, no need to worry. We are still going to bake the cake. So for that, let's go step by step. The ingredients are, this is plain flour or maida, all-purpose flour. 1 1/2 cups, 1 cup and 1/2 cup. Now we are going to use jaggery and not sugar. That is why I am calling it as a healthy cake. We need 3/4 cups. This is 1/2 cup and 1/4 cup. Totally 3/4 cups of jaggery. This is 1 cup of buttermilk. I have taken 1/2 cup of curd, mixed 1/2 cup of water, churned the two together and I have got 1 cup of buttermilk. Then this is 1/2 cup of regular cooking oil. Take some oil which does not have any flavor or smell. Simple cooking oil like sunflower oil is fine. And then this is 1/2 teaspoon of salt. 1/4 teaspoon of dry ginger powder, which is readily available. This is 1/2 tablespoon of cinnamon powder. And this is 1 teaspoon of cooking soda. Apart from that, I have taken about 1/2 cup of mixed chopped nuts, that is raisins, almonds, cashew nuts, and also some of this tutti frutti which you get in different colors, red and green. So all put together, this chopped dry fruits and nuts, say about 1 cup of it. Next, also a few drops of any essence. You can use vanilla. Today I am using butterscotch essence. This is left to you. What other things you need to do is take a cake tin. I have greased it and dusted it with some flour and kept ready. I told you we are going to bake it without an oven. So I have just taken a kadai which I no longer use, which has got a good fitting lid on it. And I have kept a wire stand on it. And this has been heating for about 10 minutes now. Similar to preheating your oven. Generally we need a hand blender for mixing the ingredients. Here nothing is required. If you don't have an electric blender or hand blender, don't worry. We are just going to use our mixer jar. Okay, shall we start? Now I have divided this as dry ingredients and wet ingredients. Okay, so first we'll mix all the dry ingredients together in a bowl and then we'll add these wet ingredients to it. So into this bowl, just before adding, we can sieve it also so that they get mixed well. Add in the flour, salt, cooking soda, cinnamon powder and dry ginger powder. Sieve it all together. This way the cooking soda, the salt, the flour and other ingredients will get mixed very well. See, all the dry ingredients have been mixed. What is remaining are these dry fruits. Add them also into it so that they get well coated with the maida. Mix it well and keep. Our dry ingredients are ready. Next, let's prepare the wet ingredients. This is jaggery. I have just powdered it at home, so to get a good mix, we'll put everything into the blender jar. Jaggery, buttermilk and oil. Just run it in the mixie for a few seconds. See, all the wet ingredients have been blended well together. Now we'll pour this into the dry ingredients and mix it all together very well. Mix it all together thoroughly. Finally, we'll add a few drops of essence to it. Mix it together and your batter is ready. We'll pour this batter into our cake tin. Our batter is ready. Just tap it for the air bubbles to go and be sure that you have left sufficient space for the cake to rise. Now this has also been preheated. Place it on the stand. I have not added any sand, salt, nothing. Just an empty container. Cover it. Keep the flame between medium and sim. And we have to cook it for about 60 minutes. So around 50 or 55 minutes, we can check it once. 60 minutes, it should be done. It is now 45 minutes since we kept it in this. Let's open it and check. Wow, it has risen beautifully. This is a skewer. Let me just check it and see if it comes out clean. Little more it has to cook. We'll keep it for another 10 minutes more. See, it is 60 minutes now. Let me open and see. Again, we'll just put a skewer inside and see. Clean, it has come out. Switch off the gas. And now we'll carefully take it out and cool it on a wire rack. So it'll be very hot. Be careful. The cake has cooled down very well. It is perfectly soft and spongy. Now at this stage, you can just cut it and use it as it is. Or being a festive season, if you want to add a little more decoration to it, we'll do a simple decoration for this cake. Here I have some pieces of cooking chocolate which I am melting in a double boiler. Double boiler means you keep water in an outer vessel, keep the pieces of cooking chocolate in your inner vessel and allow the chocolate to melt. See, the chocolate has melted well. You can switch off the gas and remove this. Allow it to cool down a bit. See, this is a strip of bubble wrap which I have taken because I want to get a lovely decorative shape around the cake. Keep this on a flat surface and spread this bubble wrap, melted chocolate on the bubble wrap like this. Carefully lift this and wrap it all along the side of the cake like this. Now just leave this undisturbed. Allow it to cool for 1 hour. After 1 hour, we'll come back and see what to do next. Before I proceed, let me clarify one thing. This cake has been allowed to cool thoroughly. Then the melted chocolate also, if you remember, I allowed it to cool totally and then spread it on the bubble wrap. And we are using it only to get that design. So there is no heat coming in contact with the bubble wrap. If you are comfortable, you can go ahead with this decoration. Now after 1 hour, let us open it and see. Just gently pull the bubble wrap away like this. Can you see the beautiful honeycomb like shape which we have got all around the cake? I have taken some whipped cream in my piping bag and we'll just do a simple decoration all around the cake. See, now our lovely eggless honeycomb cake is now ready to be served with a lovely chocolate on the outside and soft on the inside. It's a real yummy treat. See, now I'll cut out a slice of this cake and show you. There. What a lovely porous cake we have. Soft, moist, spongy with all your dry fruits, candied fruits and nuts. And here your slice of cake to be enjoyed. The honeycomb design on the outside. A little bit of whipped cream and some tutti frutti. And the lovely eggless cake. Wish you a Merry Christmas. Please subscribe to Geeta's Kitchen. Share the recipe with your family and friends. And tap the bell icon to get notifications about my latest videos. Thank you.